NSM2. Today I'm going to explain you exercise 3B, and the question is factorize each of the following expression completely. So in this question, basically you have to make the factors, and part A is a square plus 9a plus 8. The first step is that you have to multiply the first and the last number. Here the coefficient is 1. So you have to multiply first and the last number. Coefficient is 1. So 8 ones are 8. And then you have to write the mid number. That is 9. Now you have to find out those two factors, that when you will multiply them, you will get 8. And when you will add or subtract, you will get 9. So see, those two factors are, and you can go on different tables to 4s are 8, but when you will add 4 and 2, you will not get 9. You just need those two factors, that when you will multiply, you will get 8, and when you will add or subtract, you will get 9. See, 8 ones are 8, yes, 8 ones are 8. When you will multiply 8 and 1, you will get 8, and when you will add 1 in 8, you will get 9. So these are the two factors. Now what you need to do is, you will write those two factors in the place of midterm, and the first and right last term you will write as it is. So write the first term as it is, that is a square. Now in place of the midterm, you will write these two factors. Remember that this sign should come over here. This sign should come over here. Whatever the sign over here is, first you have to write that sign. And the second thing you have to remember, that first write the bigger number, first write the bigger factor. The factors are 8 and 1, so the bigger factor is 8. So first you will write 8. So in here it is a variable 8, so you will write variable a with both factors, 8a. Now second sign, you will decide that what should come. See, it is 9a, so it means that you will add 1 in 8, so you will get 9. So if this is plus, second sign should be plus, because plus plus is plus, and then you will get 9. And the second factor is 1, so you will not write 1 with the variable, just write a, 1a. Now you write last factor as it is. Okay. Now the next step is, you have to take common from these two numbers, from these two terms. So what is common from these two terms? It is a. You can see that a is common from these two terms. Now one, I have taken a common, this is a square. I have taken a common, and one a is left. So you will write a. Now plus 8a. I have taken a common, so what is left? 8. Now this sign plus. See what is common between these two. It means that when there is nothing common, it means that one is common over there. So one a's are a and one 8's are a. So you will take one common, and a plus 8 will come as it is. If your values, if you're in these brackets are same, it means that you are doing the right sum. Now take common from this and this. What is common between in this value and in this value? See, a plus 8 is common in both values. So take a plus 8 common. Now what is left in this whole value? A is left, because a plus 8 you have taken common. So what is left? A is left. And in the whole term you have taken common a plus 8. Now what is left? 1 is left. So you will write 1. So a plus 8, a plus 1 is your answer. Now I'm going to explain you B part. And B part is b square plus 8b plus 15. Again, make a small table in the side. Multiply first and the last number. Here the coefficient is 1, so you will multiply 15 and 1. 15 ones are, here it is 1. 15 ones are 15. Now what is the midterm? The midterm is 8. Write 8. Now you have to find out those two factors, that when you will multiply them, you will get 15. And when you will add or subtract, you will get 8. See, 5 threes are 15. When you will multiply 5 and 3, you will get 15. And when you will add 3 in 5, you will get 8. So the factors are 5 and 3. Again, the same thing. Write first and the last digit as it is. And in the place of midterm, you will write these two factors. Remember that this sign should come here. It is plus, so plus will come here. And the factors are 5 and 3. So first we will write the bigger factor. And this variable will come with both factors. And the second factor is 3. So you have to decide the second sign. Here it is 8 and here it is plus. So definitely you have to add 3 in 5. So plus plus is plus. So second sign should be plus. Plus 15. See what is common in these two numbers? It's b common. Now it is b square. When you have taken b common, one b is left. So write b. And in 5b you have taken b common, 5 is left. And these two numbers, you can see that 3 is common. Take 3 common. You have taken 3 common, now b is left. And 15, 3 5s are 15. So 5 will come over here. Now see, now the brackets are same. It means that we are doing the right sum. Now what's common in this whole term and in this whole term? See, b plus 5 is common. So take b plus 5 common. Now what is left inside the bracket? Here it is b left and here it is 3 left. So this is your answer. Now I'm going to explain you part C. Again, the C part is C square minus 9C plus 20. Again, the first step is that you have to multiply the first and the last number. Here the coefficient is 1. So when you will multiply 20 and 1, you will get 20. And the mid number is 9. Now you have to find out those two factors. Then when you will multiply them, you will get 20. And when you will add or subtract, you will get 9. See, 10 twos are 20. But you will not take 10 and 2 as the factors, because you cannot get 9. When you will add 10 and 2, you will get 12. And when you will subtract 2 from 10, you will get 8. You need those two factors, that when you will multiply them, you will get 20. And when you will add or subtract, you will get 9. So those two factors are 5 and 4. 5 fours are 20. And when you will add 4 in 5, you will get 9. So the factors are 5 and 4. Now see, write the first number as it is. Now in the place of midterm, you will write these two factors, and the factors are 5 and 4. Remember that this sign should come here. This is minus sign, so minus sign should come here. And then you have to write the bigger factor, and that is 5. You have to decide second sign. Here it is minus and you get 9. So minus minus is plus, so you second sign should be minus, because minus minus will become plus, and then you will add and then you will get 9c. Now write last number as it is. Now what is common in the first two numbers? C is common. It's c square. When you have taken common, one is left. It's 5c. You have taken c common, now 5 is left. Now in these two terms, you can see that you have to see that 4 and 20 are divisible by 4. It means that are divisible by 4. So you will take 4 common. Here it is minus and you will put minus. Here it is c, 4 you have taken common, c is left. Remember that whenever there is a minus sign outside the bracket, so the sign inside the bracket will be changed when you will close it or when you will open it. So I'm going to change the sign. Here it is plus. I write minus sign, because it's minus sign outside the bracket. And which time 4 is 20? It's 5 times. You write 5. See, both brackets are same. So it means we are doing the right sum. Now take common. What is common in this whole term and this whole term? You can see that C minus 5 is common. Now what is left inside the bracket is this C is left. And this 4. Minus 4. This is your answer. Now I'm going to explain you D part. And D part is D square minus 16D plus 28. Now what you need to do is multiply first and the last number. 28 ones are 28. And what is the mid number? The mid number is 16. So you have to find out those two factors, that when you will multiply them, you will get 28. And when you will add or subtract, you will get 16. So those two factors are, you will see that it's 28. So which two factors, when you will multiply them, you will get 28. And when you will add or subtract, you will get 16. So see, and the factors are 14 and 2. When you multiply 14 and 2, you will get 28. And when you will add 14 and 2, you will get 16. So the factors are 14 and 2. So D square, this sign should come here. 14D, and the second factor is 2. You need to add, so second sign should be minus, because minus minus, you will get 16. Minus minus is plus. When you will plus 14 and 2, you will get 16. So second sign should be minus, and 2D plus 28. Now in the first two term, you will take common, and D is common. D square, it is D square, so 1D is left. And these two terms, 2 is common, so you will write minus 2. And D is left. And here it is minus sign outside the bracket. So the sign inside the bracket will be changed. So this plus will become minus. And 2 ones are 2, 2 fours are 8. Now take D minus 14 is present in both these two values. So D minus 14 is common. And what is left here? D is left. And here 2 is left. So this is your answer.